Looks clear.
Yeah.
Alright, now bring the falls around on your side.
There's a lot of mobile homes here.
They look mobile, huh? They're just jacked up off the ground. No one out here can have a basement because the ground's so hard they can't excavate it. But everyone's houses are built up on stilts. And that helps in case of flooding, too.
Is there any fun activities?
I like to jump off these waterfalls. You can hike out to these waterfalls and go jumping off and splashing around in these. The natural water slide down there.
That sounds pleasant.
I like going swimming in the rivers because there's fewer things that are going to bite you than the alternative, right? Yeah, that's what I think too.
I noticed there's like a road or railroad tracks running.
I was on the radio. Can you say the first part again?
Oh, it looks like there was like a road or something that just goes like straight through there.
There is. That area right there is owned by a power plant, now a hydroelectric power plant, but back in the day it used to be owned by a sugarcane plantation. So the railroad systems are what connected all the old sugarcane plantations. And I see old railways there where there are no more working trains on the island anymore. And that gravel road is still in service with that hydroelectric power plant. They block that off so there's no car traffic on it, but you can hike out on it. You'll see a lot of old railways over on the Hilo side here.
Okay, because JT really likes the railway information.
Yeah, there was out in a town called Laupahoehoe on Highway 19, there's a sugarcane railway museum. It's pretty cool.
Where the Golden 0612 is at, and the Siren Horns has woods on it.
Did you stop by already?
Yes.
Right on. Cool.
Only one caboose.
Yeah.
And one explosives car.
Yeah.
And a small locomotive.
Did you go down to the Laupahoehoe lookout point?
Yes.
That was pretty cool there, too. See all the tsunami information there from everything that was destroyed there?
That's a yes.
Yeah. That was one of the worst areas of damage, too, I think. I got permission for us to cross over Hilo Bay and make our approach into land at the airport. Looks like we're going to follow my friend in there. I'll turn the microphones off now while we do the landing, but I'll get them back on once we touch down in just a moment. When we're on the ground, just let the crew come out. They will help you with the doors, the seatbelts. They'll show you where to go and take good care of you. If you get the chance to visit other islands anytime in the future, we've got bases on Oahu, Maui, Kauai, and Waikoloa as well. I did make a recording of our flight. If you're interested in that, it'll be waiting for you in the gift shop when we're done. Also in the gift shop, you can find ways to leave comments, feedback, and suggestions for your pilot. If you have anything to offer me in that regard, I would love to hear from you. Other than that, I just want to say mahalo, aloha, thank you for letting me fly you today. I truly hope you all enjoy the rest of your time on the island. My name is Scott. Be safe and have fun. And I'll talk to you again once we touch down here in just about 2 or 3 minutes.
Dreams that you dream of, dreams really do come true. Someday you wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where.
Alright everyone, we are back on the ground, safe and sound.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.